to our 10th anniversary concert. 10 years ago, Herb Gliick started this band, and here we are, 10 years later. I'd like to, wait, now there's Herb on timpani. He's our founder, and he knew quite correctly that Wellesley needed a town band, a community band, as part of a tradition that goes back maybe 200 years in New England, at least, of community bands today. They're going strong all over the country, and we're proud to have been here for 10 years and counting. For tonight's performance, you're going to be hearing a concert of wind band music, or concert band music, written for winds and percussion. And the start of that movement really began about 100 years ago in England with the compositions for military band by Gustav Holst, his first and second suites for military band, and Ray Vaughan Williams' folk song suite. So for our first selection, we're going back to the beginning where the English composers relied heavily upon folk melodies as the basis of their compositions for sit-down indoor wind bands that were around in England and parts of the military mostly. We're going to start off with a composition by Claire Grundman called An Irish Rhapsody, which has a lot of familiar Irish songs that you'll recognize. And Claire Grundman was a great American composer who was started around 1950 when the boom in American school bands really started, came alive with the baby boom generation. And so we're going to be starting off our performance tonight with his Irish Rhapsody by Claire Grundman.
Thank you.
very much. Irish Rhapsody by Claire Grunman. That was Max Goldenson, senior, just graduated from Wellesley High School, on the trumpet. Thank you. Our next composition is a march by John Philip Sousa by the title of Manhattan Beach. It's named for the Manhattan Beach, New York, next to Brighton Beach, which is next to Coney Island. It's got Sheepshead Bay in the back, and Verrazano Narrows in front. And Sousa composed this march when his band was playing a gig there in 1893. At that time, John Philip Sousa was about as close as you could get to a rock star in the United States. Everyone wanted to go and see his concerts, and he composed this march in honor of his stay at Manhattan Beach in New York City. In the trio, which is this sort of soft section of the march, the quiet section, you'll hear our clarinet players play ostinatos, or arpeggios, actually. Kind of an ostinato, which is a repeated pattern, and an arpeggio, which goes up and down to imitate the waves. And Sousa's idea performing this march was to start really softly during the trio, and then get loud, and then get soft, like a person who was walking down the beach and heard the band in the distance and kept getting closer, it kept getting louder, and then walked past and it got quieter and quieter. So hopefully we'll pull that off for you. Manhattan Beach. Next composition that we're going to be performing is the Nimrod Variation from Sir Edward Elgar's Enigma Variations. These were 9 different tunes, part of basically a suite of different variations, theme and variations, that he composed. Each one of them was about one of his friends. It's known as the Enigma Variations because no one's ever really been able to figure out what the main theme is that the variations are based on. But the Nimrod Variation, number 9, is the best known. And part of this is that because it's a beautiful composition, but also in British society, it's become part of their musical heritage. And for instance, it was performed at the funeral of Lady Diana, Princess Diana, and of Prince Philip, the Duke of Edinburgh. So it's a really wonderful piece of music written by Sir Edward Elgar. It's a different feel, different sort of sense of balance and everything. So it's been a challenge for us to learn and play, but I hope you enjoy the Nimrod Variation. Nimrod, by the way, was written for Elgar's friend Augustus Jaeger. If you know your German, the word Jaeger means hunter, so he called it Nimrod in honor of his friend Hunter and the legendary mythological hunter Nimrod. Of a contemporary movie themes Pirates of the Caribbean needs no introduction. We've had a lot of fun with this, and it's a great movie composition for the films with Johnny Depp. So we hope you enjoy Pirates of the Caribbean.
Thank you.
very much. Our next selection is a band concert favorite, particularly sort of pops band concerts, The Poet and Peasant Overture by Franz von Suppé. Many people are familiar with this piece from many different backgrounds, including Popeye cartoons. But it's a wonderful piece. It was written as the overture to an operetta in 1827, or 1846 actually, which is seldom if ever performed, but this piece by Franz von Suppé, The Poet and Peasant Overture, has become a standard. So we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
been doing on the solo career. Our next piece is by a very well-known American, current living American composer, Robert Shelton. He's composed many, many, many pieces. It's always being heard at band festivals and all-state competitions. In fact, he conducted all-state Massachusetts a few times. And this is his Massachusetts piece, The Fall River Overture. And it's a wonderful piece, beautifully written, sort of evokes the summer day on Mount Hope Bay, if you will. So, by Robert Shelton, The Fall River Overture.
Thank you.
you very much. Fall River Overture will be followed by a march by Henry Fillmore, the other march king of America in the late 19th, early 20th century. Favorite of her, our founder, was Henry Fillmore. We talked a lot about, we played a lot of Henry Fillmore's music over the years. And this is a particularly interesting march by Henry Fillmore called the Mount Healthy March. The story about the march is that Fillmore was told by a fellow composer that his music sold well because he was famous. So he decided to prove him wrong by composing a march under a different name, Gus Beans, like lima beans. And he named the march Mount Healthy March after a suburb of Cincinnati. Now, has anyone ever been to Mount Healthy before? Mount Healthy. Here we go. So it's I know the story about how it got the name Mount Healthy. I looked this up, so you guys can correct me if I'm wrong, but it got its name from a cholera pandemic in 1849 or something, where everyone in Cincinnati got sick, but no one got sick at Mount Healthy, so they called it Mount Healthy. It had been called Mount Pleasant before, is that right? Yeah, so we have Mount Healthy residents among us. And it's a great march, like all of Henry Fillmore's marches are. So this is the Mount Healthy March by Henry Fillmore. The last one in your program, but we might add another one at the end.
Really, the gift that you guys have given me is overwhelming. I look
look forward to every Monday night so much. Would you like to hear one more? Okay, well, this one is local. The composer's from Ashland, and it's called Our Director. And anyone who is a former Harvard student probably recognizes it as a staple of the Harvard Band. But we'll close with Our Director tonight. I should say it's by F.E. Bigelow. The March King you never heard of, probably, until now. Next concert is June 21st at Town Hall, so come see us again. We'll be playing some different songs in addition to some of the ones we just played. So I hope to see you there, and thank you very much for coming. And there is a birthday cake out in the cafeteria for everyone to celebrate our 10th birthday. So, thank you very much. Thank you all for coming.